Mike Ware, Albany High head coach. I've been here coaching for the Albany High Falcons for about 4 years now. I've been the head coach for the last three. Previously, I coached at Hudson Valley Community College. I was an assistant there for about 6 years before I took a little hiatus and rejoined the staff when Joey DiPiazza was still the head coach. Thoughts on last season? We struggled, obviously. We didn't win any games. However, we made huge strides in regards to rebuilding the program. When the previous head coach left, he graduated a lot of seniors with him, so we basically started with a bunch of sophomores. My first year, we started with 19 sophomores. The second year, those guys got a little better. They became juniors. This year, we got all those guys returning for a third year, which is very rare in high school. And they're all, you know, they're all abreast of the way we operate, the plays we run, the defense we run, and how we coach them. So I'm really excited about things going forward because everybody here is pretty much experienced and as well as pretty much experienced in regards to our culture here. This year we returned three running backs that all played varsity last year. We have two quarterbacks, one Dan Delaney, who played towards the tail end of last year, and a transfer from Green Tech, Rasir Chandler, who played and started varsity. So we have a lot of players long in the tooth returning at the skill position. We also have a kid named Andre Woods. He was a karate instructor 2 years ago and an ultimate frisbee kid. He wound up playing a little bit for us on varsity last year. This year he's due for a breakout year. He looked really good in the off-season 7-on-7s and his Schenectady camp and last week in our inner squad scrimmage as well. So we have a kid named Supreme Fitzgerald who's really talented. There's a kid named Jaylon Flowers who's a fringe varsity kid. Both of those guys are running backs slash DBs. We also have a kid by the name of Nasir Cherry who's another Green Tech transfer who plays linebacker and fullback for us. He's only a junior. He's been doing pretty good things in practice. One of our main key cogs this year will be our second year starting linebacker. He's a junior. The kid's name is Shamir LaFleur. He's a great student. He's a pretty big size kid, a la Zaquan Cantor from a couple of years ago. And he might be a little bit more athletic than that guy. So I look forward to seeing that guy develop into a stud in terms of, you know, football ability and academically as well. The kid might be a qualifier. So time will tell, but we'll see here in another year or so. Expectations this year going forward are just to be able to compete week in and week out. I think over the last 2 years, due to some of the youth that we had on the team, we struggled to compete. And then numbers were down a little bit last year as well. So we struggled to compete in the second half of games because of depth. This year, we moved to A's in hopes of having more of a balance in regards to the amount of players on each roster. So this time, you know, you play the Sheds, you play the Shakers. When their offense comes off the field, a whole new defense comes on the field. With us, our guys are playing Iron Man football. When our linebackers can't come off the field, I can't communicate with an offensive lineman after a bad drive or a bad series. So those are some of the struggles we face. This year, like I said, we're in the A's. I think things will be a little bit more balanced. We're dealing with a group of kids that have a lot more experience than previously. So I think we'll be a lot more competitive this year on a week-in, week-out basis. This year, our first three games, we open up at Green Tech, which is essentially a home game for our kids. We play there at Bleecker Stadium. However, a lot of my kids are Pop Warner guys, so they're looking forward to be able to play what could possibly be their final football game in Albany on Bleecker Stadium. So our guys are looking up for that. It's an in-city rivalry that the game has never taken place in the history of Albany, so our kids are extremely excited about opening up with those guys. After that, we go play Avril Park, which is a real tough opponent. They run a lot of double wing stuff. Not far off from what we've been doing offensively. But again, they're real technically sound and that program's been integrated in that school for a long time now. Our first home game this year is against LaSalle here in Albany. That game's actually gonna be televised. It's a 1:30 kickoff. I hope to see everybody. It's in blue. Everybody that's a Falcon, everybody in the city of Albany attending that game and cheering for us. You can find us online at the Albany High Falcons football team Facebook page. Give us a like, follow us there. This season, the hashtag for us is going to be ballin'. Capital B-E, Albany Falcon, A-L-L-N, be all in this year with the Falcons. Hope to see you guys there. Come cheer for us, wear your blue and white. Attention all Falcons, I'd like to give a special shout out to our superintendent, Quita Adams, our school principal, Jody Comerford, and the rest of the administrators for helping cheer our Falcons along and getting our guys going academically and on the athletic playing field. Also, I'd like to give a mega supersized shout out to the Falcon Nest and Falcon Nation. Come support us, 130 First LaSalle, home. Let's get it.